horror movies have made it abundantly clear over the years that death is not the worst thing that can happen to a human body. Oh no! Take a peek behind the curtain of a genre that prides itself on pant-sweating, impossible scenarios, and you will find far worse fates than simply having your mortal light snuffed out by whatever evil stalks the screen. From torture porn that is sadistically drawn out to horrendous degrees, to paranormal trappings that can condemn one to an eternity of suffering, to mentally pushing people until their minds snap like a rubber band. There are plenty of ways horror movies send a serious chill down your spine without ever killing their characters. Looking at some of the moments where death would be a mercy then, these are the movies that made staying alive the scariest horror of them all. I mean, who knew that spiders could thrive so healthily in human orifices? You learn something new every day. I am the Grim Reaper, Ash from What Culture, and these are 10 horror movie fates worse than death. 10. Becoming a Sami's Pet. Audition. Audition sees Ayama, a widower, decide to try and find another wife by setting up a fake TV audition to vet potential fiancés with. This sounds problematic, of course, and the woman he chooses ends up punishing his horn dog behaviour. Asami the scamp eventually drugs and slowly butchers him with needles upon discovering he hasn't been honest with her throughout the process near the end of the movie. But that is not the fate most terrifying here by a long shot. When Ayama is drugged, we learn about Asami's previous victim through what appears to be a hallucination in Asami's home. Kept in a sack and missing his tongue, some fingers, and both of his feet, this tortured man is forced to beg Asami for food, of which she gladly obliges by making him consume her own freshly produced vomit. Of course, this might all be a dream, but when Asami cuts off Ayama's foot shortly after, a horrible connection is drawn between the two that dictates exactly how the man could end up should Asami have her way with him. Being needled to death is nothing compared to a life inside a sack with only spew for sustenance. Ugh. 9. Living your worst fear. Dread. Dread is a little underrated horror gem that unleashed itself on the world in 2009, and is somewhat designed for a list like this with its gnarly central premise. Can you live through your own greatest fear? Setting up what's intended as a simple discussion project, one student takes things too far with those in his experiment by actually putting the participants through the horrors that they talk about. As the film devolves into anarchy, it is Cheryl, a devout vegetarian due to her father's past working at a meat packaging plant before returning home to abuse her, that gets the worst end of this deal. She's locked in a room with a steak and left to see how long it will take for her to consume it. Tortured by the smell but unable to survive otherwise, Cheryl eventually succumbs to eating it, after days of decomposition, to earn her freedom from the room. Only, her freedom she does not get. Instead, she is rewarded with a human body getting chucked in with her, accompanied by the line, "Let's see how hungry you have to be to get through that." Oh no! If being subjected to your greatest fear doesn't seem bad enough, then suffering through Cheryl's absolutely would do the trick. 8. Forcibly sectioned in a paranormal asylum. Grave encounters. It is one thing to get sectioned into an asylum you don't belong in by virtue of a sinister, money-grubbing plot, as Unsane depicts in suitably scary detail. But it is entirely another to end up accidentally committed to an institution full of evil, paranormal presences that want nothing to do with your cash, intent on literally and figuratively skewering your brain instead. And that is exactly what happens to the crew of Grave Encounters, exploring an abandoned, supposedly haunted psychiatric hospital in glorious shaky cam. We watch as they are slowly abducted and subjected to experimental treatments from beyond the grave. With Dr. Arthur Friedkin's demonic ritual practices in life, allowing him to continue his unethical mind experiments in death. The effects of this time-warping, space-altering hospital packed full of unimaginable horrors, all of which want to commit you to their world forever, is just one huge nope, really. The only way out is having your head scrambled by the evil doctor himself, but that's only if you haven't already gone insane from the hell hospital in the first place. No thank you. 7. Body switching. The Skeleton Key. Of course, Get Out absolutely takes the crown for offering up the mind-melting horrors of another person invading your body like a personal taxi, shunting you out of the driving seat to do as they please whilst you are fully aware of your own hijacking. It's a scenario that would quickly have you looking to crash your body, car, wherever this metaphor has gone, at high speeds into the nearest wall. But it's not the first movie to dabble with the terrifying potential of body switching. Granted, the Skeleton Key doesn't trap you inside your own head as another person takes over like a racist parasite, instead focusing on full body and soul switcheroos between two people. It's revealed that through the use of hoodoo, a couple have taken the bodies of younger people to thrive for far beyond their natural lifespans, jumping into them and sending their victim's soul into old, decrepit bodies that they then paralyze to protect their secret. Instead of killing their chosen targets, the duo get their power through convincing them that magic is real, then using it against them to confine them to an old flesh prison for the remainder of their drastically shortened lives. Horrible. 6. Lost in the grass forever. In the tall grass. Time loops are some of the scariest horror fates that can befall innocent characters, purely on the grounds of being stuck in a perpetual repeat of whatever awful scenario has risen up around you forever seems like the worst deal imaginable. 1408 and Triangle toyed with it, The Endless made it maddeningly real, and Happy Death Day deconstructed the trope piece by piece throughout. But I'm going to talk a little bit about In the Tall Grass instead. And why? Well, because on top of the whole endless time loop ravaging its characters into non-existence, it also has a big old alien rock sitting in the middle of it, one that conjures grass-based entities and sends those that touch it insane. Getting stuck in a time loop is bad and all, but with strange, Stephen King-curated monsters that bring you to life and condemn you to death over and over again until you become one with the strange grassy environment thrown into the mix, the hellscape becomes all the more terrifying. The grass might not move dead things, but that doesn't mean that you'll stay that way. 5. Sewn into the walrus suit. Tusk. From the title alone, this one feels somewhat self-explanatory. Films like the 2005 iteration of House of Wax have shown us the perils of being made into something no human should be, with Wade's immobility as a wax figure haunting enough for its own shout-out. Yet the walrus suit still feels like it trumps any other form of forced transformation with just one traumatizing grunt from Wallace. Sewn inside a mass of flesh after having his limbs shortened, and the resulting leftover bone crafted into tusks that are shoved into his face, Wallace's pain is palpable through the screen, and is a truly disturbing peek into what one trained medical professional can do when pushed to the limit. Whether it could actually happen in real life or not is a moot point, but the thought of being mutilated and repurposed into a walrus, of all things, is almost too bizarrely specific to comprehend. That Wallace is so conditioned to his new state of being he remains as a walrus even when he's free perhaps is the most stressful part of all. 4. Assimilation. The Thing. The idea of being warped into some sense of mass consciousness is another that has been utilized across a few movies in its time, and the mere thought of it is enough to send shivers down your spine. Or tentacles, if we're looking to The Thing for an example. There's a few different conversations on how the titular thing actually assimilates its prey, and in the absence of any truly solid facts surrounding the concept, I'm going to go right on ahead and say it is pretty horrible no matter how you look at it. Assuming hosts of the thing don't die but are taken over as the cell replication takes place, you'd then have your consciousness invaded, replicated, and shoved in with a whole bunch of other creatures from the universe over that have suffered the same cruel fate. Does that mean you never truly die and are doomed to an eternity trapped inside an alien creature using your face as bait? Perhaps, perhaps not, depending on the ambiguous truth of the movie. But the consideration of it alone is a terrifying enough prospect to make death a far more appealing option. And even if you disagree about how assimilation works, then thinking about a world overtaken where this alien exists at all is also pretty dang scary. 3. Kidnapped by an otherworldly creature. Absentia. Where we've looked at endless suffering through time loops, absorption, and sadistic mutilation intent on keeping the victim alive, there is nothing quite like an eldritch abomination to really seal the deal on a life not worth living anymore. Absentia, the vastly underrated low-budget miracle from Mike Flanagan, centers around a missing husband that inexplicably reappears again just about when he's due to be written off as dead in absentia. And whatever takes him has the manners to come back for his wife and eventually her sister too. It turns out some insectoid creature is stealing people away to a strange, paranormal realm, where they're taken through the physical wall of a tunnel and kept in another dimension by said creepy crawly. It functions as some perverse metaphor for a troll, dwelling in a tunnel, aka under a bridge, and will only let its victims go via very specific trade deals. What it does to its victims is never revealed in full, but we know they suffer an immeasurable amount, cannot escape, and can see the world going on around them whilst never being spotted themselves, which is a horrifying concept. 2. Spider eggs in the ear. The Dare. Torture movies are ripe for finding these sorts of entries, but inevitably you can argue that they're all leading up to the big event in the most imaginative and painful process possible. And can a fate be really worse than death if it's part of the process in the first place? Well, that depends on if your torturer is intent on keeping their victim alive or not. Cough, martyrs, as the Dare's Dominic is throughout his prisoner's capture. His whole sadistic deal is fueled by a big dollop of vengeance, just to make the whole experience that much more personal. And you don't really get much more personal than getting into someone's ear canal. Dominic decides that in order to pay a debt of violence back to one of the people he has captured, he's going to inject a syringe of liquid into her ear. That's fine, right? Just a little ear-cleaning remedy that might get a bit uncomfortable, but nothing too drastic. Only, suspended in this liquid are a collection of eggs. Spider eggs. Spider eggs that then hatch, work their way through her sinuses, and burst out her mouth later in the movie in a ghastly, sickening surprise. No. Just no. 1. Opening the lament configuration. Hellraiser. Struggling through the pains of a horror movie for one twisted evening is enough to make anyone reconsider just how strong their will to live is. Struggling through the pains of a horror movie for a lifetime even more so. But struggling through a pain dimension connected to hell, set up to abuse your everlasting spirit in an inescapable plane of agony, really does take the biscuit. You hear that, Pinhead? You get the top spot by a country mile. Opening the lament configuration brings about a horde of Cenobites that will judge you accordingly, potentially taking you along for the ride of their journey through time and space into all things hurt, or sending you to hell for eternal torture. The only possible good outcome is being destroyed on the spot, but that is a luxury not many get to experience. Far more scary than death is the place beyond it, and if the Hellraiser series is anything to go by, you will want nothing to do with it in the slightest. Avoid puzzle boxes, kids. You never know what you're opening up. And that's our list. What other horror movie fates are absolutely worse than death? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. I've been Ash over on Twitter at Ash Millman, and this has been What Culture. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and come back again soon for some more spine-tingling horror content. Thanks for watching.